Je remercie le représentant de l'Estonie pour sa déclaration et je donne à présent la parole au représentant de l'Indonésie.
Merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Président. At the outset, allow me to thank the briefers, USD Jean-Pierre Lacroix, Ambassador Smail Cherguy, and Mr. Konverwake. And I also would like to welcome Her Excellency Sylvie Baipo Temon, the Foreign Minister of the Central African Republic. Now, before I begin, allow me to offer my heartfelt condolences to the family of the victims of the ambush to our joint MINUSCA and FACA patrol yesterday in Nana Mambere Prefecture. Mr. President, allow me just to focus my comments on three important points. First, we need to ensure the implementation of the Bangui peace agreement by all parties. Allow me to congratulate you, Madam Minister, and the people of the Central African Republic for the first anniversary of the Bangui peace agreement in February. Indeed, the agreement remains the primary framework for restoring and sustaining peace in the country. We join the Secretary General in commending the efforts made by the government and other signatories to utilize the agreement's implementation mechanism, as well as their proactive and constructive engagement to build trust. National ownership is the key to success. The presence and ability of the government to enforce it are indeed crucial. We welcome all efforts in enhancing the government's capacity and acknowledge MINUSCA's crucial role in the country's stability. Second point, upon hearing the updates from the briefer, it is more apparent that the role of MINUSCA is more important now more than ever. MINUSCA will be pertinent in supporting Central African stakeholders in creating an environment conducive to a peaceful electoral process this year. MINUSCA should continue its efforts to win the hearts and minds of the people, including through community engagement. We are concerned about the humanitarian situation in the country, including the impact of COVID-19 in the country. The situation requires continued humanitarian support from international partners. We commend the continued efforts by MINUSCA to carry out its mandate despite some restriction caused by COVID-19. We are deeply concerned with the number of attacks toward MINUSCA uniform and civilian personnel. We also concur with those that have emphasized on the importance to put the safety, health, and security of peacekeepers on top of our priority. We have to ensure that they are safe during this COVID-19 pandemic. There are some blue helmets affected by COVID, and we hope they would recuperate and have speedy recovery and able to undertake their noble duties. Indonesia is the largest peacekeeper contributor to MINUSCA in the Council, with 368 peacekeepers, and 18 of them are women peacekeepers, will continue to support MINUSCA mandate and peace efforts. Third, as what has transpired in the region, we need to provide support and the space needed for democratic election to take place in CAR. We urge partners to increase financial assistance for CAR as they are preparing for the election. Indonesia, as an archipelagic state, have witnessed firsthand the logistic complexity of a democratic election. Democratic process is anything but easy. It is a vast logistical undertaking that requires thorough planning to anticipate all challenges, especially amidst the COVID-19 pandemic and its aftermath. We look forward to hearing updates on the preparation leading up to the election, as well as MINUSCA's role in supporting the country. Mr. President, we should continue the path of peace as laid out last year in CAR and the region. On our part, Indonesia will continue our commitment as a true partner for peace, including in the Central African Republic. I thank you.
Je remercie le représentant de l'Indonésie pour sa déclaration.